فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على من بعث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله today we're going to start the kitab نخبة الفكر. نخبة الفكر which is written by الإمام حافظ ابن حجر العسقلاني رحمه الله. Who is حافظ ابن حجر رحمه الله؟ His name is Shihabuddin. Shihabuddin أبو الفضل أحمد ابن علي ابن محمد ابن محمد ابن علي ابن محمود ابن حجر الكناني العسقلاني الشافعي. So his laqab, his nickname was Shihabuddin. His kunya was Abu al-Fadl. His name was Ahmed ibn Ali. His name was Ahmed. His father's name was Ali. His granddad's name was Muhammad. Ibn Muhammad, Ibn Ali, Ibn Mahmud, Ibn Hajar, Al-Kinaniyu, Al-Asqalaniyu al-Shafi'iyu. He was born fi Shahri Sha'ban. He was born in the month of Sha'ban. And the scholars have views regarding the day he was born. في تحديد اليوم, in terms of the day, على أربعة أقوال. According to how many views? Four views. And on the day in which he was born, four views. But the month is شهر شعبان. He was born سنة ثلاث وسبعين وسبعين وسبعمائة. He was born 773. He was born سنة ثلاث وسبعين. 773 he was born على شاطئ النيل مصر القديمة, old Egypt, river Nile. He was born there. نشأ رحمه الله يتيما, he grew up as an orphan. حيث مات أبوه, his father died, وله من العمر, and at that time he was what, أربع سنوات, he was 4 years of age. وكانت أمه, his mother was قد ماتت قبل ذلك, and his mother was one that died before that. He died before his dad. دخل الكتابة. He entered learning and education. The كتاب is a place where kids are taken to learn, to write. وهو ابن خمس سنين, when he was 5 years of age. Nursery reception. وأكمل حفظ القرآن, and he completed the memorization of the Quran. وهو في التاسعة من عمره, when he was 9 years of age. ابن حجر finished the Quran when he was 9. من عمري. وصلى بالناس, he used to lead the people the salah, the tarawih, في الحرم المكي, in the haram. He was the leader of the haram in Mecca. He used to lead the salah tarawih. At this age where he was what? سنة خمس وثلاثين وسبعمائة. This was what? سنة خمس وثمانين وسبعمائة. 785. How old would he be at that time? 12 شهرا سنة. His age was 12 عاماً, 12 years of age. So he was only 12 when he was leading the haram. وكان حين ذاك مع وصية زكي الدين الخروبي الخروبي. And the reason why he led زكريا الدين الخروبي gave the advice of him to lead the haram. And he remained with this teacher of his, Zakiyuddin al-Kharrubi. He stayed with him because his father, when he died, he advised two people to take his responsibility. This man, who is Zakiyuddin, or Shamsuddin ibn al-Qattan al-Misri. One of those two. Those two, sorry. He gave to look after him. The Shaykh, the Imam, the Hafiz, كان له من النهم العلمي الشيء الكثير. He had this want and eagerness for knowledge highly. فبعد حفظ القرآن, when he memorized the Quran, كتب شيئا من مختصرات العلوم. He started to write the abridged works, the small little books. You know these little matons that we're memorizing, these little works. He started to write on them. Ah. Some people, what do they think? These books are small. They're nothing. لا والله. They go way far. The ulama, what did they used to say? من حفظ المتون حاز الفنون. Anyone who memorizes these little fun متون that you put in your pockets, if you memorize them and you study them, حاز الفنون, you start to swim deep into the big fields. You start to what? You'll be able to go into the big fields and be able. So man حفظ المتون, anyone who memorizes these little matan that you put in your pocket, memorizes it, حاز, he starts to surpass and he starts to go deep into the fields of the books. He knows, he memorized waraqat مثلا. He'll be able to read big books now. Ha. He'll be able to study now. He memorizes, understands it, comprehends it, takes a good sharh on it. He'll be able to. So that's what he did. من مختصرات العلوم. And he wrote these some bridged books. وسمع بعض كتب السنة. And he started to listen at this age. After memorizing the Quran, he started to listen to the books of the Sunnah. Such as what? كصحيح البخاري وغيره. Like صحيح البخاري and other than it. فلما قارب العشرين, when he reached 20. That's all that happened before 20. All of that is before 20. And now some Muslims are struggling to even hear what? أربعين نووي. Some Muslims have never heard of أربعين نووي or studied it. Let alone بلوغ المرام العبد الحكام أو بخاري مسلم داود تلميذ ابن ماجه. 40 hadith. No, you can count Muslims who have actually sat down and memorized these 40 hadith and understood these 40 hadith. Little. قليل ما هم. Little are they. So when he reached the 20 years of age, فاق أقرانه, he surpassed his colleagues. في فنون الأدب, in the field of literature. He surpassed him in the field of literature. ونظم الشعر الرائق, and he passed him in poetry. He could do poetry at the age of 20, write poetry. وكتب النثر الفائق, he started to write work. واهتم بالتاريخ وعلومه, and he read history and matters pertaining to that field. I read it, looked at it. This is all at the age of 20. ولما بلغ من العمر 20 عاما, when he reached 20, لكن حبب الله, Allah put in his heart something different, which is what? Allah put in his heart علم السنة, started to like the field of the sunnah. فأقبل عليها إقبالا عظيما, he's put his mind, his thought, his conscious, his efforts, everything he put into the sunnah, learning it. In what way? سماعا, listening, gathering, he went to the city, circles of knowledge and he started to listen. وقراءة, and reading it. ومشاركة, and participating in it. Is that all? But rather, وقد رحل تحصيلا للعلم, he traveled and he strived and he went to places. وتطلب للشيوخ, to become student for these scholars that were around. إلى كثير من البلدان, he went to many cities and many towns and many places. غير مكتفي بمصر, and he didn't suffice himself to Egypt. And he said, oh, I'm in Egypt, so I'm just going to stay in Egypt. No, and its scholars وعلمائها, and its scholars. فسافر إلى اليمن, he went to Yemen. والشام, he traveled to Sham. والحجاز, he went to Arabian Peninsula. وأخذ العلم عن مشاهير علمائها, all the well-known scholars at that time, he went and took knowledge from them. وبلغ, it reached عدد شيوخه, the number of teachers that he took from, سماعا, in terms of listening, وإجازة, and giving him إجازات, وإفادة, in which he benefited from, نحو 500 شيخ, 500 scholars, 500 people he took from, في سائر العلوم والفنون, in all different fields of the religion. وبخاصة, specifically the fields that he took the most from scholars was what? الفقه والحديث. فقه الحديث. ومن أهمهم, from the most well-known scholars in which he took from Awasu, عفيف الدين النشاوري, he took from him, who died the year 790. He took from Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn Zahira al-Makki, he took from him. He took from Abul Hassan al-Haythami. Abul Hassan al-Haythami. He was the man shahida libn Hajar bittaqaddum. He was the one who gave Ibn Hajar, put him forward. He was the one. Bal, he was the one. Sarrah bil-istifadah minhu. He was the one who clearly said, he told the people to benefit from him. He was. Ibn Mulaqqin, rahimahullah. He's the one who we take the sharh Umdatul Ahkam that we're studying currently now, the kitab we take from Al-I'lam bifawa'id Umdatul Ahkam. Ibn Mulaqqin was the teacher of Hajar, rahimahullah ta'ala, who done a sharh on Bulugh al-Maram. sorry on Umdat al-Ahkam. And he also has Sharh Sahih al-Bukhari ibn Mulaqin. Also, who did he benefit from? Sirajuddin al-Bulqini. Sirajuddin al-Bulqini is his teacher. He took from. وهو أول من أذن له بالتدريس والإفتاء. And he was the first person who gave him permission to teach and give fatwa. He was the one. Who was it? Sirajuddin al-Bulqini. Also, the sixth scholar that he took from was Abu al-Fadl al-Zainuddin al-Iraqi. Zainuddin al-Iraqi. He was the first person who called him what? وهو الذي لقبه بالحافظ. He was the one who called him what? حافظ. And we're going to come to that term, what it means. وعظم شأنه. And he put the status and the position of Ibn Hajar high. وفخم أمره. And he blew and grew his matter and said, this is Ibn Hajar. He praised him so much. وشهد له. And he witnessed for him. بأنه أعلم أصحابه بالحديث. He bear witness to him that he is the most knowledgeablest man of his students in hadith. He gave it to him. وغيرهم, and other than those scholars have praised him, rahimahullah. Now, many of you may think, okay, that's good, mashallah. What's that different? Brothers, your teacher is praising you. You know, a student praising his teacher, okay, that's heard, it's known. No problem. Because he's a student who's learning, he sees big of his teacher. No problem. Like when an alim, who is well known in his field, says to you, you know what? Allahu Akbar. And calls you by the title of Hafiz. This is an ijaza that is strong. As for his students, أَمَّا تَلَامِيذُهُ His students, فَقَدْ تَوَافَدُوا فَقَدْ تَوَافَدُوا عَلَى مَجَالِسِهِ مِنْ كُلِّ حَدَبٍ وَصَوْبٍ His students, they have come from all over the places of the world. They studied with him and took from him. His students were كَثُرَة وَكَثُرَةَ طَلَبَتُهُ His students became excessive in number. حَتَّى كَانَ رُؤُوسُ الْعُلَمَاءِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَذْهَبٍ مِنْ تَلَامِذَتِهِ To the extent that the people who were the leaders of their madhabs in their field were studying in his gathering. They were coming to Ibn Hajar's gathering. حَتَّى ضَاقَتْ بِهِ مَجَالِسُهُ Until he circled the circles he wished to teach at, it became very tight. Very tight. وَامْتَلَى بِمَجْمُوعِهِمْ مَدَارِسُهُ The gatherings, the people were coming, the places got full. No one could come. People were coming the day before. And they were doing i'tikaf there the day before so they can participate in his lessons. And from the students who came, who came out from his madrasa, خَرِّيجُهُ وَخَصِيصُ وَنَاشِرُ عِلْمِهِ Every teacher, remember, has a distinctive student who brings out his knowledge, who works hard for his teacher. Like Ibn Taymiyyah, who do we, he had a lot of students, but who is, when we look at Ibn Taymiyyah, is always, he's a khirijo, and he's a khasiso. And he stood up for the his belief and pushed it up and worked and praised him. And who's it? Which student was it? Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah. Ibn Hajar, like that, was al-Sakhawi, rahimahullah. Shamsuddin al-Sakhawi. He pushed Ibn Hajar and he spread his knowledge around the world. Al-Biqa'i, second one is al-Biqa'i. Baqa'i, who was also the student of who? Ibn Hajar. Ibn Qadi Shuhbah. Ibn Qadi Shuhbah. Also, Ibn Ta'ri Bardi. Ibn Fahad al-Makki. And other than them, they came. Ibn Hajar, rahimahullah, he wrote a lot of books. A lot of works he has. And we're going to mention some of the names of the books in which he wrote. He wrote the Kitab Fathul Bari, which is the Sarah of Sahih al-Bukhari. He has a book called Tahdhib al-Tahdhib. Which is the six books of hadith. All the men that are in there, he writes it in that book. It's originally taken from the book Tahdhib al-Kamal by Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi, which is originally taken from the Kitab al-Kamil by Abdul Ghani Abdul Wahid al-Maqdisi. Lisan al-Mizan, which is a work which he done on Mizan al-I'tidal by Ibn Hajar, Dhahabi rahimahullah. Dhahabi's book, Mizan al-I'tidal, Ibn Hajar came and he put a work on it and he called it Lisan al-Mizan. He also has Talkhis al-Habir. تلخيص الحبير is a تخريج of the كتاب فتح العزيزي فتح رافعي الدر الكامنة تغليق التعليق إنباء الغمر بأنباء العمر he has works he's a lot of books he taught رحمه الله في مدارس عدة he taught in many madrasas many schools he taught the schools that he taught It reaches 20 madrasas. Remember that at those times there were madaris. Madrasa fulani, مدرسة الأشرفية، مدرسة العمرية، مدرسة دو مدارس that existed. And to go to those مدارس you weren't just an easy person. You had to be a man, جلالة, an علم. You had to teach. He reached 20. And he was a قاضي. He became a judge. قاضي رحمه الله. He used to teach تفسير. He used to teach حديث. He used to teach فقه. He was شرع بالإملاء. He used to sit down and give dictatorship. He used to dictatory. The hadith. He used to dictate it. And he carried on dictating it. واستمر إلى أن مات until he died. رحمه الله. فكان محصلة ذلك ما يزيد على ألف مجلس. And that was 1,000 sits. Where he gave dictator. He dictated. He taught. رحمه الله. He took قضاء. He became a judge. رحمه الله. And he was a قاضي. 21 years of his life. He was a qadi, a judge. He sat in the court. He also gave khutbah, and he used to do khutbah in Jami' al-Azhar. He used to do it. And also Jami' Amr ibn al-As. He used to give. He took mansab al-ifta. He became a mufti. أكثر من 30 سنة. More than 30 years he was given fatwa. And he was a mufti. وبعد هذا كله. After all of that which is mentioned, brothers. عفى الله عنه. May Allah forgive him. كان ذا عقيدة. He had the عقيدة. يشوبها عقيدة that wasn't pure and clean. In what matter? في تأويل الصفات. In distorting and interpreting the characteristics and the attributes of Allah تبارك وتعالى. And sometimes he contradicted himself. مع اضطراب في ذلك أحيانا. Sometimes he would contradict himself. And if you want to see those mistakes he had in his عقيدة, then go back to the تعليقات of العلامة سماحة الوالد. عبد العزيز ابن عبد الله ابن باز رحمه الله in which he has on his in his فتح الباري ابن باز رحمه الله he put a تعليقات on فتح الباري ابن باز it was read on him and he was putting a bit of تعليقات on it رحمه الله the عقيدة issues there is actually right now there's a رسالة written by شيخ عبد علي بن عبد العزيز الشبل حفظه الله he's still حي في قيد الحياة he's still alive he wrote a رسالة He called it, I think, مخالفات العقدية في كتاب فتح الباري. The عقيدة problems that are in فتح الباري. He wrote them every page and he points. And scholars have praised this book. شيخ صالح الفوزان, شيخ محمد صالح العثيمين, I think, if I'm not wrong. عبد العزيز بن باز رحمه الله تعالى. And علماء praised that book by that sheikh. Where he brought the mistakes of ابن حجر رحمه الله. توفي, he died, ابن حجر died. بعد حياة حافلة بالعلم النافع. He died a life after he filled up his knowledge. He filled it up with what? Beneficial knowledge. والعمل الصالح, righteous actions. Ha. As that which we think. فيما نحسبه. That which we think of him. Inshallah. ولا نزكي على الله أحد. And we're not going to praise anyone in the eyes of Allah تبارك وتعالى. فرحم الله وعفى عن. May Allah have mercy upon him and forgive him. بمنه وكرمه. If you want to read more into his biography. And you want to see more of how he was, and you want to know more about Ibn Hajar, and you're eager to know more about him, and this is not enough for you. You need to know more, because this was nothing except bullet points. You can go back to Dhaw al-Lami', Dhaw al-Lami', Dhaw al-Lami', written by his student, al-Sakhawi, who talked about his teacher. You can also go to the Kitab al-Tibr al-Masbuk, also by Sakhawi himself as well. You can go to Nazm al-Iqban, written by Jalaluddin al-Suyuti. And حسن المحاضرة by جلال الدين السيوطي أيضا too. You can go to شذرات الذهب by ابن عماد. You can go to قلائد الجوهرية لابن طالون طولون. ابنه طولون. رفع الإسر. رفع الإسر. Which he done a ترجمة. رحمه الله. He done a ترجمة of himself. He spoke about himself. If you go to البدر الطالع by شوكاني you also find it. الفهرس الفهارس by الكتاني. And other than that. ومن أوعب ما ترجم به أحد. Any biography that was written about his life. The best one that's been written. It can be said that any ترجمة, biography that a person has been done about a person, the best book that ever has been done for a person's biography. Best is الجواهر والدرر في ترجمة الشيخ الإسلام بن حجر by his student السخاوي رحمه الله. The best. Three volumes. قد طبع كاملا في ثلاث مجلدات. He speaks about his teacher in a very good way. Also, Dr. Shakir Abdul Mun'im, He also wrote Isti'ab Jayid Lihayati wa Ulumi wa Sunafati, where he followed up his life, his knowledge, and the works and the books he authored. And he called it Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani wa Dirasatu Musannafati. Ah, he wrote about it. Nah.